A long-awaited victory for Filipino caregivers. The city attorney announced it had reached a settlement against Evelyn Nishi and her company's Health Alliance Nurses Corporation and Hand Home Care Provider, Inc. The case had begun 3 years ago as caregivers claimed that the companies were paying them as little as $5.50 an hour for 24-hour days, which the companies had denied.
This was not an isolated case. Most, if not all, Health Alliance and Hand Home Care workers were extremely underpaid. They were robbing us of our hard-earned wages.
It's no longer acceptable to pay people a daily one-time flat rate that does not take into account minimum wages and overtime protections.
The settlement awards workers $250,000 in restitution. It also places a $100,000 fine and an injunction against the defendants that would limit workdays to 12 hours, guarantee overtime for people that work beyond 9 hours a day, and would require audits. Since the case against them first surfaced, Health Alliance had argued that their workers were self-employed independent contractors. The injunction now requires that caregivers be hired as employees.
With this resolution, we are sending a very strong message to employers, and for that matter, employees throughout our region. To employers, we make clear, we continue to aggressively pursue alleged wage theft, and we're gonna be on the case again and again. And to employees.
The restitution will be distributed after the affected workers, which is believed to be as many as 200, are identified. For Bikar, she says she has no plans with her award.
This is for everybody. Not only for me, whatever will come out, okay, no problem. It's not on the monetary side. It should be on the movement side, that everybody will have a fair chance.
Feuer adds that this is the first wage theft case that a public law firm has successfully settled under the Domestic Workers Bill of Rights.
For the workers, their advocates, and attorneys, this settlement goes beyond the former employer and their industry. They say it's a victory for all workers in LA, especially as the city gradually increases towards a $15 minimum wage by 2020. Steve Angelos, ABS-CBN News, Los Angeles.